जे आर मेहता। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट सोलर कूलिंग विच इज अ सस्टेनेबल टेक्नोलॉजी फॉर कूलिंग। द आउटलाइन ऑफ दिस प्रेजेंटेशन, इंट्रोडक्शन विच गिव्स यू नीड एंड बैकग्राउंड, सोलर कलेक्टर्स, डिफरेंट रूट्स एंड टेक्नोलॉजीज फॉर सोलर कूलिंग, COP or that is coefficient of performance versus the firing temperature for vapor absorption machines, collector type and cooling technology, flat plate collector details and references. The need for solar cooling. It's known that air conditioning creates a burden on electrical grid, particularly during peak summer season. The energy consumption for cooling in India is rising rapidly because of various reasons, like commercial building space is growing, there are more superstores with the changing lifestyle of people and expanding economy, higher quantity and size of refrigerator in domestic market. Peak electrical power deficit in India is reported to be around 12.3% between 2003 and 2010. So we need to change this scenario and reduce electrical energy consumption for air conditioning. On the other hand, most of the electrical power comes from fossil fuel consumption, mainly from thermal power plants. So there is a need to reduce fossil fuel consumption because the fossil fuel resources are depleting and there are pollution concerns related with the burning of fossil fuels. Solar energy is a good option for cooling because India is blessed with high solar insolation intensity. Solar energy does not create pollution while generating energy. There is nominal cost of running for most solar collectors, and its solar energy is a local source and there is no transmission or transportation needed, which again is helpful to increase the overall efficiency. Solar cooling, what are the different routes and technologies? One way to produce cooling is to use solar photovoltaic collectors, as it is shown here, and the other way is to convert solar radiation into thermal energy. If you convert solar energy into electrical energy, you can run a vapor compression cycle with the help of that and produce cooling. If you convert it into heat, then there are various methods to produce cooling. One of the categories is heat transformation process, the other is thermomechanical process. We are going to focus on heat transformation processes, where it can be done in an open cycle or in a closed cycle. In open cycle, you have options like liquid desiccant or liquid sorbents and solid desiccants. In closed cycle, you have options like liquid sorbent and solid sorbent, which are nothing but vapor absorption and vapor adsorption technologies. Vapor absorption machines, what is the COP? The ideal COP is given as TC upon TH into TH minus TM upon TM minus TC, where TC is the cooling temperature, TH is the temperature at which the heat is supplied into the system, and M is the ambient temperature. So this is the ideal COP whose graph can be seen here. So as the temperature increases, the efficiency increases nearly linearly, but the real machines cannot provide such high efficiencies, as it can be seen if it is a single effect vapor absorption machine. This is the efficiency you get as the temperature rises, but at higher temperatures the efficiency become flat, and it's if energy is available is at a higher temperature, then it's advisable that you go for double effect machines. And if temperature is even higher, one can go for triple effect machines. And as the number of effects are more, the efficiency will be more. But you will be using different type of collector, that is a better quality of collector if you want a higher temperature. Here, solar cooling, the thermal route is shown, what are the different types of collectors which can be combined with different cooling technologies. So those domains are shown. The three lines here indicate the generator temperature versus solar collector efficiency. Generator temperature is nothing but the supply temperature from the solar collector. So as the supply temperature from solar collector increases, the losses from solar collector increase, so the efficiency goes down. So the collector with the lowest efficiency is an air solar air heater or air collector, which is suitable only for liquid desiccant cooling. It can be liquid desiccant or can be solid desiccant. The dashed line here is for flat plate collector, which is generally solar water heaters, and it may be suitable for somewhat higher temperature desiccant cooling or even for adsorption. The collector having highest efficiency are evacuated tube collectors, which are suitable for high temperature adsorption, single effect absorption, as well as double effect absorption. Double effect absorption gives you higher COP, but then the solar collector efficiency is somewhat lower as compared to the low temperature single effect absorption process. The collectors for solar cooling, one of the collectors is explained here, illustrated here, which is a flat plate collector. These are the typical components of a flat plate collector. You have glazed panel or the glass cover at top. You have two headers. This is the header tube at the bottom from which the cold water enters, and you have outlet. Cold water enters from here, and you have outlet from here where the hot, from where the hot water comes out. You have the tubes connecting the two headers, and these tubes are in contact with the absorber plate, in good thermal contact with the absorber plate. So the absorber plate is the plate which absorbs solar radiation, which passes through the glass cover. It absorbs a large part of it, becomes hot, and supplies heat to the water in the riser tube. A riser tube is a tube through which the cold water rises up as it becomes hot and comes out of the outlet tube. And you have the bottom insulation to reduce the losses. And this shows how the collector efficiency decreases as you have more and more temperature difference between the liquid at outlet and the ambient temperature. If you use the AR is anti-reflective. If you use a better anti-reflective coating on the glass, then you can expect better efficiency, and if you use more number of glasses, the efficiency will go on increasing, particularly at higher temperature differences. But obviously this will also increase the costs. This presentation has been prepared with the help of the references mentioned here, and I thank you for their inputs. Thank you.